So, welcome back, students, to another important lecture. So, today we are going to discuss for the second year people a very important concept. Now, that will be applications of potential difference. So, in the last class, I told you the concept of potential difference. So, now we are going to discuss some very good applications based on the potential difference. Now let us see what the application will be saying. Now the application will be saying, now consider a uniform electric field acting in the horizontal direction. Now A and B are two points. A and B are two points inside the electric field separated by a distance d. A constant potential difference capital V is applied between them. A charged particle of charge Q and mass m is released from rest at point A. So now you are supposed to find what will be the velocity that will be acquired by the particle at point B. So very simple application we got. So consider a uniform electric field acting in the horizontal direction. Now A and B are two points inside the electric field, now separated by a distance small d. A constant potential difference capital V is applied between the two points A and B. So now what we are doing, a charged particle of charge Q and mass m will be released from rest at point A. So now we are supposed to find what will be the velocity that will be acquired by the particle at the point B. So that is the application we got. Now let us see what will be the velocity that will be acquired by the particle at point B. So if you bring in the application, now I will just remove this application, and now let us see how to find the velocity at point B, or how to obtain the expression for the velocity at point B. So now, according to the problem, now we got a horizontal electric field. So we got a horizontal electric field, and what we are doing, it is given that there are two points. Now point A and point B, now both of them, they are separated by a distance d, and moreover it has been given now the potential difference that will be applied between the two points will be capital V. So now let us say we got a horizontal electric field. Now consider two points, now point A and point B. Now both of them, they are separated by a distance d, and moreover we are applying a constant potential difference capital V between the two points. So now what the problem is saying, now at the point A, now we are keeping a charge Q. Now let us say this will be our point A, now this will be our point B. Now what we are doing, we are releasing a charge particle Q from point A from rest. Now given that, now we are releasing the charge particle, or we are releasing a charge particle Q from rest at point A. So now we need to find, now what will be the velocity that will be acquired by the particle at point B, or what will be the velocity that will be gained by the particle at point B. So what I will do to make it more clear, I will draw a free body diagram. So now what I will do, I will draw a free body diagram or a simple diagram. So according to the diagram, now remember, now we got now one point A and the other point will be B. Now given that the separation between them will be small d, and the potential difference applied between the two particles will be capital V. Now what we are doing, now at point A we are releasing a charged particle from rest, or from point A now we are releasing a charged particle from rest. So now we need to find, now what will be the velocity that will be acquired by the particle at point B, or what will be the velocity that will be gained by the particle at point B. So it is very clear. Now consider two points A and B, now inside the horizontal electric field. Now both of them, they are separated by a distance d, and we are applying a constant potential difference capital V now between the two points. Now remember, now what we are doing, we are releasing a charge particle Q, or what we are doing, we are releasing a charge particle Q from rest at point A, and now we need to calculate, now what will be the final velocity that will be gained by the particle at point B, or what will be the final velocity that will be acquired by the particle at point B. So very simple. Now what I will do, I will remove this diagram. Now we are already taken the free body diagram. So now let us see, now how to tackle the first bit. Now what I will do, now you already know, now what is the definition of the potential difference. Now potential difference will always be defined, now work done per unit charge. Now you already know, now potential difference will always be defined, the amount of work that has been done per unit charge. Now what you do, now if you cross multiply, so therefore the amount of work done will be numerically equal to now V into Q. So we are getting the amount of work done will be numerically equal to, now V are multiplied by Q. So now what you do, now apply the work energy theorem. Now you already know, now according to the work energy theorem, now whatever amount of work that will be done on the particle will be numerically equal to the change in the kinetic energy of the particle. So you already know from the work energy theorem, now whatever amount of work that has been done on the particle will be numerically equal to the change in the kinetic energy of the particle. So we mean what? Now work done will be numerically equal to the final kinetic energy minus the initial kinetic energy will be numerically equal to Vq. Now this can be further written. Now you already know, now what is the final kinetic energy? So the final kinetic energy will be numerically equal to half m v square, now minus the initial kinetic energy will be half m u square, will be numerically equal to, now we get, now v into q. So I can write, so work done is numerically equal to the final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy will be numerically equal to now V into Q. But you already know, now the initial velocity will be zero. Now whenever the initial velocity will be zero, then the initial kinetic energy will also be zero. So therefore, now what we are getting? So I can write, now half m v square minus 0 will be numerically equal to Vq, or I can write, now half m v square, will be numerically equal to capital Vq. Now that's the reason why, now I can write, now V square will be numerically equal to 2Vq divided by M. So V square will be numerically equal to not 2Vq not divided by M. So therefore, the final velocity that will be acquired by the charged particle at point B will be numerically equal to now under root of 2Vq now divided by M. So remember, now that will be, the final velocity that will be acquired by the charged particle at point B, or the final velocity that will be gained by the particle at point B will be given by the formula, now under root of 2Vq now divided by M. So remember, now that will be the velocity that will be acquired by the charged particle at point B. So first step. So if you have taken now, let us come here. now the second bit will be now second bit now the second bit now you need to find now what will be the acceleration of the particle. So now let us see now what will be the acceleration of the particle or what will be the uniform acceleration of the particle now inside the electric field or what will be the uniform acceleration of the particle in the uniform electric field. So how you are going to calculate the acceleration? So you can calculate the acceleration now by applying the kinematical equation now v square minus u square will be numerically equal to 2as. Now remember it's a one dimension motion. Now the particle will be accelerating along the horizontal direction or the particle will be moving in the one dimension of motion. That's the reason why you can apply the kinematical equation. Now v square minus u square will be numerically equal to 2ax. So we already know now what are the conditions given. Now you already know now the conditions which are given. Now here the initial velocity will be equal to zero and the displacement covered by the particle will be numerically equal to d. So now we need to find now what will be the acceleration of the particle. So if I substitute in the above formula, so what I get? So v square minus 0 square will be numerically equal to 2ad. Now implies now v square will be numerically equal to 2ad. So therefore, so now I can find out now what will be the acceleration of the particle. So therefore now the acceleration of the particle will be numerically equal to now what we get now v square divided by 2d. So the uniform acceleration of the particle will be numerically equal to now v square divided by 2d. Now we already got the final velocity. Now we already got the final velocity that will be acquired by the particle. Now substitute in this formula. So what we get? Now A will be numerically equal to 1 by 2d. Now multiplied by v square. Now you already know the final velocity gain will be given by the formula. Now under root of 2vq divided by m whole square. So now what you do if you simplify it? So now if you further simplify it, so what you are going to get? So acceleration will be numerically equal to now 1 by 2d now multiplied by 2vq now divided by m. So therefore now 2 and 2 will get cancelled. Now what we are getting? The uniform acceleration of the particle will be numerically equal to now vq divided
So remember
the uniform acceleration of the particle will be numerically equal to now v cube now divided by md. So remember now that will be the expression we got, or that will be the formula we got for the uniform acceleration of the particle in the uniform electric field. So A will be numerically equal to now V cube divided by MD. So that will be the uniform acceleration required in the uniform electric field. Now once you are through with this concept, or once you are through with this concept, now let us come to now one more important point, or let us come to the third bit. Now let us see now what the third bit will be saying. Now let us come to the third bit and let us see now what the third bit will be saying. So now the third important bit, or the third important obligation. So now I want to find now what will be the time. Now what will be time required by the particle, or I can say now what will be the time taken by the particle, not time taken by the particle, time taken by the particle to reach the point B. So now the next important thing, not time taken by the particle to reach the point B. So now let us see now another very important bit, now another very important concept. Now let us calculate now what will be the time that will be taken, or what will be the time that will be taken by the particle to reach the point B. Now to find the time, now very simple, now apply the kinematical equation, or apply the kinematical equation. Now V will be numerically equal to U plus KT. Now you already know, now here, now initial velocity will be equal to 0. So therefore, the final velocity will be numerically equal to now what we are going to get. So V will be numerically equal to 80. So therefore, now what is the time taken? So therefore, now time taken will be numerically equal to now V divided by A, or the time taken by the particle, now T will be numerically equal to the final velocity, not divided by the acceleration of the charged particle. Now substitute now both of them, so time taken will be numerically equal to, now you already know the final velocity gain will be given by the formula, now under root of 2v cube divided by m, now whole divided by now acceleration we already got, now v cube now divided by md. Now substituting now both the final velocity and the uniform acceleration Now what we are getting, not E, now the numerical equal to, now under root of 2VQ divided by M, now whole divided by, now VQ divided by MD. So now further we need to simplify. So if I remove this one, now let us see now what will be left over to what will be left over. So therefore, so I can write it, now time again will be numerically equal to now under root of 2vq now divided by m now whole multiplied by now what I get it, now md divided by now md divided by vq now what I will do now I will take now the entire thing under the root or what I will do now I will take now all the terms under the single root so what we are going to get so that time again will be numerically equal to now under root of now what we get now 2vq divided by m now multiplied by now what we get now m square d square now divided by now v square into q square so very simple now what I am doing I am pulling all the terms or what I am doing I am taking all the terms under the single root so what I am getting now under root of now 2vq divided by m now multiplied by now m square d square now divided by v square q square so what will happen now 1vq and 1vq will be getting cancelled now 1m and 1m will be getting cancelled so finally now what will be left over so therefore now finally now what will be left over so that time taken by the particle to reach the opposite point B or that time taken by the charged particle to reach the opposite point B will be given by the formula. Now what will be left over? So in the numerator we got not 2m into d square now whole divided by it. So we are getting not 2m into d square now whole divided by it. Now what we are going to get now v into q. So that will be the expression we got or that will be the expression we got for the time taken by the particle to reach the opposite point B that will be given by the formula now T will be numerically equal to so under root of 2m d square now divided by vq so remember now that will be the formula we got for the time taken by the charged particle in order to move from point A to point B so you can also verify you can also verify the formula by one more method or you can verify now whether the expression will be correct or not by applying one more equation so now to verify now whether I got correct or not so very simple now you can apply now one more equation Now even you can apply the formula, I should say, now another method or what we call allocate or another method. Now I can also apply the formula. Now S will be numerically equal to now UT plus half AT square. Now you already know, now here the initial velocity will be equal to 0 and the displacement covered will be numerically equal to small d. So now you can also verify the formula for that time. So by applying now one more equation, now S will be numerically equal to now UT plus half AT square. So you already know now the initial velocity will be 0 and the displacement covered will be numerically equal to E. So if you substitute in this formula, so what I get, so S will be numerically equal to now 0 plus half A T square, or what I am going to get, now S will be numerically equal to now half A T square. So now you can verify, now are we getting the same formula or not. So now further, now what I can write, now implies now T square will be numerically equal to now 2s divided by A. So T square will be numerically equal to now 2s divided by A. So therefore the time taken will be numerically equal to now under root of 2s by A. Now substitute, now what is S and what is the uniform acceleration. Now you already know now what will be the value of displacement, and you also know the acceleration of the particle. Now substitute in the formula. So implies the time taken will be numerically equal to now under root of 2d now divided by, so acceleration will be now vq now divided by md. Now md will be coming or to the numerator. So if md will be coming or to the numerator, so time taken will be numerically equal to now under root of now 2m d square now divided by vq. So again we are getting the same formula. So the time taken by the particle, will be numerically equal to not 2m d square not divided by vq. So we are verifying the formula for that time. So by both the formulas, now we are getting the same expression. So the time that will be taken by the particle in order to move from point A to point B will be numerically equal to now under root of 2m d square now divided by vq. So that will be the time taken by the particle in the uniform electric.
demonstrate.
Now let us come to one more important bit. Now there will be the fourth important bit. Now there will be can anybody not tell me now what will be the de Broglie wavelength? Now what will be the de Broglie wavelength of the particle? So what will be the de Broglie wavelength of the particle at point B? So now let's see, now what will be the de Broglie wavelength of the particle at the point B, or what will be the de Broglie wavelength that will be associated with the particle at point B? So now you already know now that de Broglie wavelength lambda will be given by the formula. So lambda will be numerically equal to now h divided by momentum. So you already know now de Broglie wavelength will be given by the formula now Planck constant divided by the momentum of the particle. That can be further written. Now lambda will be numerically equal to now h divided by mv. So what you need to do? Now very simple. Now substitute the formula for the final velocity that will be acquired, or substitute the formula for the final velocity acquired by the particle, you will be getting the de Broglie wavelength. So therefore, now lambda will be numerically equal to h divided by m into the velocity acquired will be given by under root of 2vq divided by m. Now if I take the whole thing under one root, so I can write now lambda will be numerically equal to now h divided by now what I can write now 2vq now multiplied by m square now divided by m. So what will happen? Now m and m will be getting cancelled. So m and m will be getting cancelled. So finally, now what will be left over? So therefore, the de Broglie wavelength of the charged particle will be numerically equal to now h divided by, so we get now h divided by, now we are going to get now under root of 2mvq. So very simple thing. So very simple thing. So what we are getting, the de Broglie wavelength of the particle, or the de Broglie wavelength of the particle at the point B will be numerically equal to now h divided by now under root of 2m into vq. So remember, now that will be the formula we got for the de Broglie wavelength. So lambda will be numerically equal to now h divided by now under root of 2vmq. So that will be the de Broglie wavelength of the particle at the point B, or that will be the de by the formula, so lambda will be numerically equal to rho h divided by rho under root of 2v into m cube. So that will be the formula we got for the de Broglie wavelength. Now let us come to one more important bit.
This will be the magnitude of the electro
charged particle, or this will be the magnitude of the electrostatic force that will be experienced by the charged particle now inside the electric field. That will be now one more a fantastic concept, because now one more tremendous concept we got. So what will be the force that will be experienced by the charged particle in the electric field? That will be given by F, will be numerically equal to now VQ are divided by D. So now coming on to the last important concept. So now the last important concept, now let us see now what will be that. So now I want to find now what will be the magnitude of the uniform electric field. So now I want to find magnitude of uniform electric field. So now let us see now how to obtain the magnitude of the uniform electric field. Or now I want to obtain now what will be the magnitude of the uniform electric field that has been applied in the horizontal direction. So can anybody now tell me now how to find the electric field, or how to obtain the magnitude of the electric field? Now very simple. Now you know now force experienced by the charged particle in the uniform electric field will be given by the formula. Now F will be numerically equal to QE. So now you already know the electrostatic force that will be experienced by the charged particle now inside the electric field will be given by now F will be equal to QE. But just now we got the formula for the electrostatic force, but force will be numerically equal to now what we got, now VQ divided by D. Now just now I obtained the formula for force, so force will be given by now VQ divided by D. Now that you substitute in the above equation, so therefore I can write now VQ divided by D will be numerically equal to QE. So what will happen? Now Q and Q will be getting cancelled. So what will be left over? So finally, now what will be left over? So we are getting the uniform electric field will be numerically equal to V divided by D, or if you cross multiply, the potential difference will be numerically equal to now E into D. So remember, now that will be the expression we got, or that will be the formula we got for the magnitude of the uniform electric field that will be given by now E will be numerically equal to V by D, implies the potential difference applied will be numerically equal to ED. So might have understood the concept very well. Now keep on watching the videos. You are getting some fantastic quality material for JEE, for NEET, for intermediate. Everything has been given on the board. Excellent material for JEE and NEET, for CBSE 12, senior intermediate. So keep on watching the videos, and I want a more number of comments in the comment box. So nobody is giving any kind of comment. So I want your comments in the comment box. So thank you for today. So thank you. Thank you very much.